Jared Polin, FroKnowsPhoto.com, and this is your sleepy time.
Don't forget his nap.
Photo news fix. This fix is brought to you by Squarespace. My personal website, JaredPolin.com, is still used building Squarespace, and I wouldn't use anything else if you're a photographer or a creative. It's so simple, it's easy, affordable, and you don't need to know coding, Steven. No freaking coding. To get your 14-day free trial with no credit card needed, head on over to squarespace.com/FroKnowsPhoto, and if you decide that it's for you, use the code FroKnowsPhoto at checkout to get 10% off your first order. First up, a story about Fuji. Now I know, hold all of the applause. Actually, don't hold all of the applause. Everybody start clapping. I want to hear it for the Fuji news. That's right, thank you for the applause. Now many of you have been asking for me to talk about Fuji news, so here we go. Fuji has just announced the replacement to their super popular X100F. Introducing the X100V, which stands for
Victory!
Okay. It doesn't stand for victory, it stands for five. Because it's the fifth version of the camera. What else would it be? The X100V is a fixed lens camera that I like to dub the poor person's Leica. Now it sports an all new fourth generation 26.1 megapixel X-trans BSI CMOS sensor and a fixed 23mm f2 lens that in full frame 35mm terms gives you a 35mm equivalent focal length. This new lens is said to have higher resolution, lower distortion, and improved close focus performance. Fuji is claiming that the hybrid viewfinder is vastly improved with a 3.69 million dot OLED EVF. Now I did own the second generation X100, which was called the X100S for second generation, and I can tell you I love the hybrid viewfinder option, but with that being said, I didn't exactly love the camera, mostly because it didn't play well at higher ISOs and was very limiting with just a fixed lens. And because of that, I ended up trading it in. Nonetheless, the design of this camera takes on a very classic look that, if it's anything like the older ones, is still a little more difficult to hold without adding any accessories. Now, if you're interested in this camera, it will come in silver and black at a price point of $1,400. But the real question is, who is it for at that price? Because would you be better off buying a Z50 for $900, a Canon EOS RP which is full frame for $999, or something like the forthcoming Fuji X-T4,
this is awesome!
Which still keeps you in the Fuji world, but lets you actually switch between lenses. At the end of the day, I think this camera is more for someone who already owns and loves Fujis, but wants something slightly smaller and a little bit more limiting when they're traveling. Which would you buy? An X100 or something else. Nikon Japan has let the world know that the new Nikkor Z70-200 2.8 VRS lens will, in fact, be coming right on time.
Yeah, buddy!
And by right on time, I actually mean it won't be coming on time and it's actually delayed.
Hey, kids.
Because it seems like that's what Nikon does now. Every time they release something new, it gets delayed. So here's the Google Translate for what Nikon Japan had to say. The release date of the Nikkor Z70-200 2.8 VRS lens, which was announced to be released on February 14th, 2020, which is Valentine's Day, by the way, has been postponed due to production reasons. We apologize for any inconvenience this may cause to customers waiting for this product. Steven, I actually think a lot of people would be waiting for a zoom lens on Valentine's Day.
I could do it again if you need a close-up.
Petapixel went ahead and asked Nikon USA for a quote while they were at it, and it looks like Madeline K responded by saying, "We apologize for the delay of the Nikkor Z70-200 2.8 VRS lens. We are currently making final adjustments as part of our production process in order to ensure the highest quality product. We will provide availability as soon as possible." Let me translate Nikon USA's bullshit statement in real talk. We f***ed up. We're not even sorry either, because we know if you haven't jumped to Sony just yet, you're not gonna leave us this late in the game. Come on, Nikon, you had one job, and now I'm switching to Sony. But really, you had one job. Look at Canon. They keep leaking shit, and you can't even get shit out.
Come on, you gotta relax. Don't force it.
Oh, by the way, if you think I look tired, that's because I'm filming this after being up for 32 plus hours straight.
You're gonna have to quit being a...
And finally, Canon has showed their hand and plans to launch an advanced EOS R model according to their 2019 financial results.
Are you excited?
Feel these nipples!
Well, Steven, I guess that depends on who's paying us more, Canon or Sony. So who's paying us this time?
Squarespace!
That's right, Steven, Squarespace! Canon's report still showed the 15% a year downward trend in prone advanced amateur sales to the tune of 8.8 million units in 2019 and are projected to be down to 7.5 million units in 2020. Canon has also said they will improve their product mix, which can only mean one thing, a new calculator.
Useless machine.
Actually, Mr. Tanaka said, although we have launched 2 full-frame mirrorless cameras, as well as 10 dedicated lenses, and let me jump in here and say that one is a real full-frame camera, the other is the RP. It's real, but it's a wannabe full-frame camera. Continuing with the quote, our lineup is still insufficient. In order to recover from our late entry into the mirrorless camera market, we have plans to launch a model that incorporates a newly developed image sensor and image processing engine that offers even more advanced features. Can we just point out that Canon is admitting that they were late to the mirrorless game, but are actually going to go all in making future pro mirrorless cameras a reality? With all of that being said, the EOS R5 is starting to look more and more real every single day. Now, speaking of Canon rumors, they shared some specs of an EOS R6 that will have a 20 megapixel full frame sensor, IBIS, shoot 12 frames per second mechanical and 20 frames per second electronic. And once again, how do I not call bullshit on the fact that this thing could shoot 12 frames per second, let alone 20, because that's what the higher end models are supposed to be doing. Now, other possible specs include 4K at 60 frames per second, a new battery, and a release date of June 2020. Now, I need you guys to remember something. I've been saying Canon's a sleeper of the bunch for well over a year at this point. This is 2020, or as Barbara Walters would call it, Canon's
2020.
Do you like this news? Do you still shoot Canon? And there you have it. That's the very sleepy version of Photo News Fix this time around. To check out the last fix, go ahead and click on the screen right here. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I'm gonna go pass out. Thank you very much for watching. Jared Polin, FroKnowsPhoto.com. See ya.